right. So we are going to talk now about animal rotation, and we're going to look at my chicken rotation garden. So I have this chicken coop here in the middle, and then I have doors on each of the corners of the chicken coop. And what I do is seasonally, I will open one door and I will keep the chickens in one of these paddocks. And I usually keep the chickens in the paddock for about 3 to 4 months, right? So I had the chickens in here in these two paddocks all winter. And then when springtime came, I had planted garlic in this paddock over here. And when the garlic got big enough that the chickens could no longer disturb it, I moved the chickens in here to weed a lot of the plants around the garlic. And now the chickens are in this paddock. Now, animals in rotation can be a really beneficial way to manage your landscape. I have some problems here, right? And one of my problems is called bindweed. And this is a really voracious weed that takes over. So part of my chicken rotation is managing this and other really intense weeds I have. Because I had the chickens in here and they were keeping it as that bindweed was coming up in spring. They were just scratching and scratching and disturbing and never letting it get a foothold. And then when I moved them here, I planted immediately. I got my plants, I got them ahead of the bindweed, and then I mulched heavily. So I'm still weeding the bindweed out of here, but the chickens really helped to hit it back in the springtime, and now they're keeping it down in this paddock as well. So there's a lot of different things throughout the year, throughout the seasons, that I'm using the chickens very strategically to hit a certain plant in order to prepare the garden for my next crop. I'm also taking all of my household waste. I'm bringing other biomass material in. I'm putting it in here. I'm giving it to the chickens. They're foraging, they're scratching it up. They're helping to manure and fertilize the soil. So these soils have a lot of nitrogen from all the chicken manure. Now, you might say that it's inappropriate to have chickens in here with a crop that I'm about to harvest. And the truth is, this wouldn't really meet food safety standards for the FDA or something. But for a crop like garlic, where the bulbs have so many layers of thick skin, the ground is really hard right now, and I'm gonna dig all these up and I'm gonna hang them and I'm gonna dry them and I'm gonna clean them off, I feel pretty safe about contamination. However, like I said, this wouldn't pass the FDA sniff test. So you have to be aware of that, especially in a commercial type of system. It's really important. This chicken coop is actually south-facing, passive solar. I have a window there because chickens actually lay with the light, right? When the light increases, their laying increases. So I want to maximize solar access because I'm here at 45 degrees north latitude. So it's not just chickens that you can use in a beneficial way as far as rotation. Many other animals, actually, if they're part of a rotational system, can be part of your fertility management. They can be part of your weed control. I found it really helpful because honestly, the chickens actually do the majority of the work for me in preparing these gardens and managing them at certain points. So let's look at a few more details of the system. So the back of the chicken coop is actually connected into my greenhouse. And so I collect the eggs through the greenhouse. This has the benefit of keeping this nest box warmer in the wintertime. So the chickens are laying in a warmer environment. So there's some kind of thermal exchange here. And it makes it really easy for me just to come in and collect the eggs. This hen right here is broody, so she's not very happy about the idea of me coming in and getting her eggs. So I won't show you that on film right now. I'll have to get them later.